Hey guys, this is Melissa Martini on behalf of designbundles.net. Today we're going to be talking about the nesting feature on Silhouette version 4.1. The first thing you're going to want to do is go ahead and open up your Silhouette Studio. We're going to select the nesting icon over here on the right toolbar. It almost looks like two hands that are holding each other. Once you open that up, you're going to see you have a few different options. The first thing you can do is use the cut area, which is the size of your mat, exactly what media you're cutting on, or you can actually use a selected shape as a boundary, but we'll get to that in just a moment. The first thing we'll do is select all of our shapes, and let's just say we have double this amount that we need to cut. So I'm just gonna copy and paste. I know I have quite a few more shapes here. So I'm gonna select everything, and I'm gonna hit nest. Now, the padding will change the spacing between each item. So if you don't mind them being super close to each other, you can leave the padding at 0 or 1. If you want them to be spaced out a little bit so you have some room to work, just go ahead and space them out some. The align option will try to put like objects together. So it may try to keep as many of the hearts together as it can, or as many of the stars together as it can, just to make it cut in the most efficient way possible. And the rotations option allows the shapes to be rotated. So if you need them all to sit exactly as you see them on your screen, you want to leave the rotations at 0. If you don't mind them rotating a little bit to, you know, 90 degrees, 120, 180, 270, you can change the rotation options. So this is going to let it rotate in 2 different angles. This will let it rotate in 4 angles and so on as you go up to a higher option. So we're just going to leave it at 0 for now and hit nest. Now you see what it did. We have our spacing at 13, so you can see some of the items are spaced out. This is how many it could fit on the mat right now. And then what it will do is you can cut these and then go on to cut the next set of objects. Now if we were to take all of these, let's just select everything again and change our padding to 0 and hit nest. You can see how many more it fit on there. There are times whenever it doesn't calculate correctly. So if you have things overlapping, let's just go ahead and move them off the mat. We'll hit Command A, I'm gonna hit Align. Let's do our padding to like 3 and hit Nest. Okay, so since we did Align, it tried to fit as many hearts as it could on here, and then it saved the stars for the next go around. So that's what it will do whenever you're using the cut area as your option. Let's pull this out. We're going to select the star and make it just a little bit larger because this is now going to become our cut area. We're going to take this selected shape and click Set Selected Shape as Boundary. Now this is our boundary. Go ahead and select our items and hit Nest, and it's going to fit as many as it can within this boundary. And that, once again, is with the padding at 3. If we go back here and we change the padding down, we may be able to fit more items within here. If you feel like you can fit something else, you can go in and try to put it in yourself, but it might just poke out just a little bit, which is why it doesn't include it. But another option is playing around with the rotations. If you're okay with the items being rotated a little bit, you can change this and hit nest, and it may be able to fit more items within the star because of the fact that it can rotate a little bit. Okay guys, I hope that answers any questions you have about the nesting feature. If you have any remaining questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. Give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time.